dear friends, welcome to Top Education. In this session, we are learning Chapter 3, Valuation of Goodwill. So here, we'll do valuation of goodwill. And guys, here we have few methods. We have to go according to this. So goodwill is an intangible asset. Okay, so it is an intangible asset also. It can be realized along with the other assets. See, now if you have furniture, you can sell it out. Like that only, the goodwill also can be realized. It does not become obsolete. It doesn't not suffer from depreciation, but is subjected to fluctuation. But the goodwill is not having any depreciation, but what happened here is it fluctuates. As the customer are decreasing, the goodwill also decrease. See, goodwill means name, fame of the business. For example, I can say the goodwill of Jio is very good. So the goodwill of Jio is also got some importance. There also they can earn money. So guys, here there are method of valuation of goodwill. So we have to do this 5 methods. Actually, yes sir. No, 4 methods. So there is average profit method. In there we have simple profit, weighted profit. Then we have simple profit method, capitalization method, capitalization of average profit, capitalization of super profit, and last but not least, annuity method. So here guys, what happened is, in average profit method, you will minus the remuneration. First you will add all the profits, then you will minus all the remuneration, then what you have, the profits, that you will divide by the number of the years. So you will get average profit. Okay, weighted profit also same, total product divided by total weight. So you will get this weight method, weight profit. Super profit method, where you will get this super profit into there is some formula for super profit method. Let's see here, what is the super profit method formula? Yes, so here we have method. Under this method, a certain number of years of the super profit are considered as for the valuation of goodwill. To calculate the goodwill under super profit method, calculation of average profit, as I said, what we have to do. Then again we have to do calculation of capital employed, where you will that is also a similar way which I will show you. Wait a second. Like a calculation of adjusted super profit, steps in calculation. This is capitalization method. Here only, see. So there are different methods here. If you guys know the formula, then it is very easy to see or solve the question. So this is, I think, simple method, where in the question they have given the amount for this year, this much. So we have written as it is. Total profit for the 4 years, as we have written here, total it up. Then divided by 4. We are doing this divided by, because there is 4 years, we are dividing by 4. Then average, adjusted average annual profit, where we are minusing the remuneration. So then we'll get the adjusted average profits. That adjusted average profit is multiplied number of years of purchase, which will be given in the question only. So into, you'll get the answer as goodwill. So that there are different types of sums also, more and more. So first we'll know the 1-1 method. Each will go in each and every method. Okay, so average profit method, calculation of adjusted profit. So as I said here, all the profits minus all the profits divided by how much? Sorry. So here, divided by number of years. If over stock of calculation is there, over valuation opening stock, payment of dividend to preference shareholders, provision for taxation, all you will minus here. This all you are minusing. See, look out here, expectational incomes not likely to occur, non-operating incomes, all you are minusing here. Add abnormal loss, non-operating expenses, undervaluation of closing stock. So this will come for 6 marks. super profit will come for 14 marks. I can surely say you guys that super profit will come for 14 marks, and the simple sum where you will add and minus that add and deduct that adjustments, there you will get for 6 marks. So by that you will do calculation of adjusted profit. It is average adjusted profit, total adjusted profit divided by total number of years. Okay, so done. Then weighted total product divided by total weights. So weight aito adjusted aito ivaga super profit alli same aatharane your less. So here this you will do this also. Then here the calculation of normal profit using super profit has 5 steps. Guys, super profit has 5 steps. First step is where you do on the basis of net asset, on the basis of shareholder. If you are doing on the basis of net asset, you are minusing the present value of market value of assets minus liabilities, then half of the current year profit. Only for super profit method you are doing this. On the basis of net asset, market value minus present value liabilities, then less half of the current year profits. Then on the basis of shareholders' interest, this I think it will not come for each and every time. So here also what happened is profit on revaluation of assets and liabilities. So what we have got, the profit will add here debit items of shareholders like preliminary expenses, underwriting commission, discount on issue of shares, debit balance, profit and loss, all will less down. Loss on revaluation, non-trading assets, goodwill, all will minus, and we'll find out half of the current year profit also will minus. Then we'll get average capital employed. This is another method. This is another. But this method is used in our syllabus. This method is rarely used. So this is first method. Asset minus liabilities, then half of the current year profit is equal to average capital employed. So here you will come step 2. Step 3, I think. So here, calculation of normal profit using the following formula. Normal profit, what you have got the answer, take down here into normal rate of returns as it is. Calculation of super profit, average adjusted profits. Average adjusted profits where you got in the step 1, that minus normal profit step 3. So this, then calculation of goodwill, super profit into number of years of purchase as it is. But here when it comes to capitalization method, value of the business, average profit adjusted divided by into 100 divided by normal rate of return. So there also you will have something different called. Okay, so we'll learn in these others. Annuity method where you will have into, that's it, they will give a percentage or a number, small number, 0.345 something. So we'll multiply goodwill, super profit into present value of rate, present value of rupees. So you will get this annuity method. So that's it guys in this video. For next video we are doing few sums which are very very easy. Guys, this chapter is also very easy. If you think it is easy, if you practice, then only you can do it. If not, you are nothing. So thank you guys for watching this video. If you like, then please subscribe our channel Top Education. Thank you.